and the era of fluoridated toothpastes and mouthwashes. It makes no sense to have fluoride in our water. The evidence against fluoride is overwhelming.
Health Secretary Robert F. Kennedy Jr. calling on more states to join Utah in banning fluoride from public water supplies. Kennedy says its use can lead to IQ loss, bone weakness, liver problems. Joining us right now is Dr. Todd Ellerin. He's the vice chair of medicine at South Shore Health. You just heard the secretary.
Yes.
I mean, he's firm in his commitment with this.
Right.
And right or whether, we could argue that. So let's talk about that. Question one, arguments against fluoride in the water. But here in Massachusetts, what, about 62% of people live in communities that do have it. Do you think that those 62% of the communities in the state have something to worry about?
Definitely not.
Not.
What we've shown over many years, decades, is that fluoride in the water leads to better oral health. Fluoride helps essentially the enamel of our teeth and prevents decay. So what happens if you don't have enough fluoride is that you can get worse cavities and bacterial infections, bad oral health. But you don't want to get too much. You don't want to have too much fluoride in the water. And basically the Goldilocks number right now is 0.7. And that number was reduced back in 2015. It was between 0.8 and 1.2.
Right.
And so I think this strikes the right balance between good oral health and not having to worry about a reduced IQ.
And that number you're talking about is the amount in water, right?
That's right.
That 0.7 up to 1.
That's right, because there have been studies that have shown if you have too high of a dose, you can reduce IQ a bit in children. But that's more than twice the levels that are in the
You're not buying
waters.
The jump to IQ, right? I mean, you don't believe that this is affecting that?
Not at the current levels
I got
that we
you.
Have.
So let's talk about your specialty infections. There are new concerns this week about Group A strep, do I have that right?
Yes.
Group A strep. Is that the same bacteria that causes strep throat?
It is. It's the same bacteria that causes strep throat. But it's not, there was a study that was just published today that showed that from 2013 to 2022, there's been a doubling of invasive group A strep infections.
Okay.
That's not just strep throat,
right,
okay?
Right.
And this was in populations like over 65, okay? And injection drug users, homeless, and Alaskan Natives and American Indians.
What about children?
Interesting you say that. Even though some pediatricians think they see anecdotally more cases, this study did not show an increase in invasive group A strep infections in children. And I want to point something out. It's scary to hear about a doubling,
right,
but we're talking about something like 3.6 per 100,000 patients in 2013 to 8.2 per 100,000 patients in 2022. So yes, it's a doubling, but still the absolute risk is low.
It's a doubling, but the number is smaller in comparison with the larger scale.
That's
we also
right.
want to talk about the big change at the federal level. The CDC closes a national lab to track sexually transmitted diseases. Does that have a local impact?
It does. Well, the problem is we're talking about a lab at the CDC that is essentially looking for resistance in things like gonorrhea. And the problem is right now we only have one antibiotic left that reliably treats gonorrhea. So without this lab, we can't measure and then monitor trends in resistance of this important organism. And that's a problem. And they don't just monitor, but they also help with guidelines and help with testing.
Right, right.
And help, you know, with novel therapeutics. So
right.
it's a special lab. So hopefully it can come back.
Dr. T, great to see you as
you
always.
Too. Take
Thank
care.
You.